Hi, this is Bill Carmody with a review of Impressionism. The interests of French artists in light and color led to a style characterized by blurred images that convey the impression of a scene instead of an actual representation. In music, Impressionism is used to describe the works of Debussy and his followers, principally Maurice Ravel. Debussy was influenced by the 1889 World's Fair in Paris, for which the Eiffel Tower was built. Travel at this time was difficult, long, and expensive, so most Europeans saw these authentic represented cultures, people, costumes, food, and music for the first time. Debussy, who is now 21, studied how the music from other countries sounded unique without imitating the German masters of Bach, Mozart, Beethoven, Brahms, Wagner, and so on. He noticed that widely used non-tonal pitch sets, modes, and non-major minor scales. They had unique orchestrations, a lot of use of percussion for sound effects rather than for dramatic emphasis. They often had very intimate combinations of instruments, the use of harp with flute, rather than full orchestral power. Debussy and Ravel looked for ways to make their music sound unique and different from the major and minor type scales that were used in tertial harmonies. So, some Impressionists used modes. Here's an example of a piece written in a Dorian mode. Other types of scales were also explored. Here's a pentatonic scale in a piece by Debussy. Debussy especially liked using whole tone scales. In addition to using different scales, Impressionist composers made extensive use of extended harmonies. They created their own chords by the use of addition and omission. So they would add a note to a chord to just make it sound a little different. Or they would take notes away from chords, especially the third. So without the third, there's no way to identify it as either a major or minor triad. Sus4 chords were also used, and they did not resolve. Did make for a new sound. Sometimes they would include both the major and minor third into a chord, so again, you can't tell if it's a major or minor triad because it has both kinds of thirds in it. And they created chords built on other intervals, especially the fourth, called quartal harmony. In addition to traditional 5-to-1 cadences, the Impressionists also use other harmonic relationships to end sections or pieces. Here's a linear cadence. The root of the chord becomes unclear when the chord factors change as notes are added and removed. What was the root becomes the third or another factor. Third relationship progressions are the most subtle, also called substitute progressions. The music is pleasing without being consonant. Here's an example of a quasi-authentic cadence. It's 5-to-1, but not in a major or minor key. And with no leading tone, the pulling tendency and predictability is absent. Previously forbidden parallel intervals were exploited. Planing uses functional chords in a non-functional way to create a rich sonic effect. Since much impressionistic music avoids traditional major and minor tonalities, other ways must be found to analyze it. If you can identify the compositional technique being used, point that out. If not, simply report what you do recognize. The use of scale fragments, metric and rhythmic patterns, homophonic or polyphonic sounds, or whatever gets your attention. Often techniques are mixed from section to section or even from measure to measure. So just do your best to point out what you can find to point out. The following short song, it's only 15 measures long, uses several of the techniques covered in this chapter. This, quote, barely tonal music is open to several opinions of analysis. It tends to be more subjective and leads to interesting discussions. Don't hesitate to put forth your own observations. The first measure is analyzed for you to get you started. And here's what it sounds like. Just use macro analysis because Roman numeral doesn't make any sense here. Good luck in your analysis and exploring impressionistic composers and expressionistic music. Debussy's music often has a sense of lack of gravity, like a cork in the ocean, because there's no tonal center for you to grab onto. But it's very interesting and pleasant music, so enjoy listening to it and analyzing it. Bye-bye.